Scopolamine is a belladonna alkaloid with anticholinergic effects indicated for the treatment of nausea and vomiting associated with motion sickness and postoperative nausea and vomiting, PONV. In this video, let's find found. What is scopolamine? What is scopolamine used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking scopolamine? How does scopolamine work? How to use scopolamine? What is scopolamine? Scopolamine, also known as hyoscine, or devil's breath, is a natural or synthetically produced tropane alkaloid and anticholinergic drug that is used as a medication to treat motion sickness and postoperative nausea and vomiting. It is also sometimes used before surgery to decrease saliva. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. What is scopolamine used for? Scopolamine is indicated in adult patients for the prevention of nausea and vomiting associated with motion sickness and for the prevention of postoperative nausea and vomiting, PONV, associated with anesthesia or opiate analgesia. What is scopolamine used for? Scopolamine is indicated in adult patients for the prevention of nausea and vomiting associated with motion sickness and for the prevention of postoperative nausea and vomiting, PONV, associated with anesthesia or opiate analgesia. Side effects. Uncommon, 0.1 to 1% incidence. Adverse effects include dry mouth, anhidrosis, reduced ability to sweat to cool off. Tachycardia usually occurs at higher doses and is succeeded by bradycardia. Urticaria, hives. Pruritus, itching. What is scopolamine used for? Scopolamine is indicated in adult patients for the prevention of nausea and vomiting associated with motion sickness and for the prevention of postoperative nausea and vomiting, PONV, associated with anesthesia or opiate analgesia. Mechanism of action. Scopolamine acts as a non-selective competitive inhibitor of M1-M5 MACARs, albeit with weaker M5 inhibition. As such, scopolamine is an anticholinergic with various dose-dependent therapeutic and adverse effects. The exact mechanisms of action of scopolamine remains understood. Recent evidence suggests that M1, and possibly M2, MACHR antagonism at interneurons acts through inhibition of downstream neurotransmitter release and subsequent pyramidal neuron activation to mediate neurological responses associated with stress and depression. Similar antagonism of M4 and M5 receptors is associated with potential therapeutic benefits in neurological conditions such as schizophrenia and substance abuse disorders. The significance of these observations to scopolamine's current therapeutic indications of preventing nausea and vomiting is unclear, but is linked to its anticholinergic effect and ability to alter signaling through the CNS associated with vomiting. Half-life. Following removal of the transdermal patch system, scopolamine plasma concentrations decrease in a log-linear fashion with a half-life of 9.5 hours. Dose. Nausea and vomiting. Treatment. 0.3 to 0.65 mg 4/IM/SC, repeat Q6-8HR if necessary. Motion sickness. Prophylaxis. Apply one patch behind least 4 to 12 hours, preferably 12 hours, before anticipated exposure to motion, then every 3 days PRN. Nausea and vomiting associated with anesthesia. Prophylaxis. Transdermal patch. Apply one patch behind ear on night before scheduled surgery. Leave on for 24 hours after surgery. Caesarean section. Apply one patch behind ear 1 hour before surgery. To minimize newborn exposure, apply no sooner, remove 24 hours after surgery. Chemotherapy-induced nausea and vomiting, off-label. Apply one patch, Q72HR. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category, not assigned. That's all the information about scopolamine we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.